Hello children, welcome back to the science class. Already we have completed two units. In this session we are going to see about unit 3, changes around us. Changes around us. Changes takes place around us all the time. See these pictures, crumbled paper, burning wood, rusted nails, crushed can, cooked egg, bending metal, melting ice, and bleaching cloths. These are happening every day around us. Some changes having physical properties and some changes having chemical properties. A change refers to an alteration in physical properties or alteration in the composition of matter. For example, ice melts on heating, that is, it changes from a solid to liquid. On further heating, water starts evaporating, it changes from a liquid to gas. So here there is a change in the physical state of the substance. Let us look at other change. That is, when objects made of iron are exposed to moisture conditions, a reddish brown new substance called rust forms on the surface of the object. So some changes having physical change, physical properties, and some changes having chemical properties. We'll see one by one in this class. From this example, crumbled paper, next crusted can, melting ice, bending metal, these are having physical properties. And burning wood, rusted nails, and cooked egg, and bleaching cloths, these are having chemical properties. First we'll see physical changes. Physical changes are the changes in which only physical properties of a substance undergo a change and there is no change in its chemical composition. So there is no new substances formed in a physical change. So physical properties include luster and inductivity, density, viscosity, solubility, mass, volume, and so on. Any change in these physical properties is referred to as a physical change. For example, when a rubber band is stretched, it enlarges. How, when the stretch is stopped, the rubber band comes back to its original state and shape. In this example, there is no new substance formed, but the rubber band remains the same before and after elongation. So melting, freezing, changing state, and breaking, cutting, squeezing, mixing, dissolving, these are physical change. An example of physical change: tear a paper, folded a chair, table, or anything, and mixture, cut the paper or any other, and plates broken into pieces. These are examples of physical change. Next, chemical change. Chemical changes, a change where a new substance is made and it has at least one indicator. The five indicators are temperature change, color change, gas produced, light produced, and precipitate. So five indicators happen in physical changes. The examples of physical changes are burning of coal, burning of candle, rusting of metal, explosion of firecracker, and decomposition of organic matter, and ripening of fruits. These are examples of chemical changes. Effects of heat on solid, liquid, and gases. Upon heating, particle arrangement within the state of matter gets disturbed. The disturbance is seen either as expansion or contraction. When heated or colder, the object may expand or contract, but the mass remains the same. That is the number of particles that was inside the object does not undergo any change. Only the arrangement of the particle changes. When a glass of water is heated, its volume increases, and if a glass of water is colder, its volume decreases. So solid always rigid, fixed shape and fixed volume. Liquid not rigid, no fixed shape and fixed volume. And gas not rigid, no fixed shape and also no fixed volume. Characteristics of a physical changes. A physical change has following characteristics. Characteristics of physical changes. During a physical change, only physical properties such as size, shape, color and state only changes. But no new substance will come. During a physical change, no new substances is formed. And a physical change can be either reversible or irreversible. Dissolving sugar, for example, dissolving sugar in water is a reversible change. No very small amount of energy is either absorbed or evolved during a physical change. So, a physical change is usually temporary and reversible in nature. For example, when water is heated, water vapors are formed. Once water vapors are cooled, water can be obtained again. Next, in physical change, the physical chemical properties of a substance do not change. For example, when a piece of gold is melted, its chemical composition remains the same in the solid form and also the liquid form. Changes of state. Change of state of a substance is one of the major physical change we encounter in daily lives. We have read about simple changes of physical state such as melting of ice in our previous classes. The following are some of the changes of state. From solid to liquid is melting. From solid to gas is vaporization. From liquid to solid is freezing. From gas to liquid is condensation. From solid to gas is sublimation. So, increase in heat energy, solid will come to gaseous stage, that is sublimation. And when solid is heated, solid is melting and become a liquid. After liquid again heating, the liquid will convert to vaporization and gas is formed. When decreases in heat energy, the gas is condensation, gas formed liquid, and after is cooling, liquid is cooling, that is freezing, next solid is formed. So melting, vaporization and sublimation occur when heated and hence it is called as endothermic process. In an endothermic process, the speed of the molecules is increased, hence move faster. In contrast, such as in freezing and condensation, heat is removed, resulting in the decreasing the speed of the molecules, causing them move slower. Such process are called as exothermic process. So in endothermic process, heat is increased and exothermic process, heat is decreased. Melting. You have seen a bottle of water getting pulled around the glass of ice cream or a glass of ice cubes, when it kept in room temperature, the ice cubes or ice cream melt, right? Can you give reason for that? The ice kept in the beaker receives heat from the surrounding air to make and form water. So when solid heated, liquid is formed, and when liquid is cooling, the solid is formed. Next, vaporization. Look at a kettle kept on the fire. The bubbles form and the liquid water become water vapor. If you heat in suspectively, however, when you put a wet cloth to dry, the water evaporate into air, leaving the cloths dry. That is, there are two types of vaporization, boiling and evaporation. The first one is by heating, and the second type of vaporization is natural. Boiling is the process of convention of a liquid into vapors on heating. In gaseous state, only the arrangement of molecules changes. There is no change in their chemical composition. So boiling is a physical change. So vaporization, the amount of energy required to move a substance from liquid to gas is referred to as the heat of vaporization. So Q equal to NH vaporization. Q is denoted as energy required, and N is number of molecules, and H is the joule by mole. Evaporation. Evaporation is a process in which liquid state changes into a gaseous state due to an increase in temperature and or pressure. Evaporation is the technique used to separate dissolved solids from a solid liquid mixture. This is the technique used to extract salt from seawater in salt pans. For example, from drying cloths to drying fish, evaporation is used. Next, freezing. To freeze means to change a substance from a liquid to a solid state by cooling it to the freezing point. Particles of a liquid convert in particles of a solid. Only change in state from liquid to solid takes place during the freezing of water to form ice, but no new substance is formed. So the freezing of water is a physical change. Next, condensation. Condensation is the conversion of gas into its liquid state. The liquid obtained after condensation can be converted back into gas on heating. So condensation is also a physical process. During this process, only the arrangement of molecules changes from the gaseous state to liquid state. So condensation also is a physical change. Gas is cooling, liquid is formed. Liquid is heating, gas is formed. So condensation is the changing of a gas into its liquid state, and it happens by cooling. Whereas evaporation is the changing of a liquid into its gas state, and it happens by heating. Condensation, the process by which water vapor in the air is changed into liquid water. Sublimation. What is sublimation? Sublimation is the process where a solid changes phase and turns directly into gas without passing through a liquid phase. So ice sublimation directly convert the vapor. This process in which a solid is converted directly into gas is called sublimation. There are certain solid substances like camphor, naphthalene that get converted into gas directly upon heating without becoming liquid. This is sublimation. Crystallization. Crystallization is a method of separation as well as a method of purification. The crystal or salt obtained by the process of evaporation are small. The shape of crystals cannot be seen clearly. So the solid substances are usually purified by the process of crystallization. Large crystals, pure substances, can be obtained from the solution by the process of crystallization. So, crystallization method is a method of separation as well as of purification. Thank you, children. We will see about chemical changes in our next session. Thank you. We'll meet the next session.